Pag gumisima letter chai, man.
Show going on right now, which is the letter chai, guys. Don't miss it ever, 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 ever.
Hey y'all, what's going on? It's your girl Noor. Welcome to Letter Chai. And today I'm here with my special guest. This is Cuckoo. Is it Cuckoo?
Cuckoo, yeah.
Cuckoo, sorry. Gloria and Nabil. You guys are doing an event called AWA.
Yeah.
Can you guys tell us a little bit about that?
It's that AWA is stands for African Women Acting. Mm-hmm. So it was created by Sonia Emi, an artist, a Nigerian artist.
Okay.
Yeah, and the goal is to empower women through art, right?
Yeah, we need that.
Exactly.
Seriously, yeah.
Exactly.
Okay.
So every 2 years, we have a festival.
Right.
And then we have women come, sing, you know, play.
Everybody do their own part. Like
exactly.
Singers,
exactly.
Dancers,
singers,
actors.
And exactly.
Okay,
exactly.
That's
and
cool.
This year, the theme is, we pay tribute to Miriam Makeba.
Who is Miriam Makeba?
Well, Miriam Makeba, and I think she is the best person
for
that.
She's the queen, of course.
Exactly. And,
I will take that. Well, Miriam Makeba is a South African icon.
Okay.
I remember watching her as a child on television on black and white, through black and white interviews, and she was a beautiful singer, an activist, a woman who was not afraid to speak her mind, and she fought apartheid through music.
Amazing.
She fought apartheid through the arts, you know. Every time she stood on a stage, she had something to say,
yeah,
you know, and that brought about change in South Africa. We all know what South Africans went through, mm-hmm. through apartheid, and we are aware of it. So her fight, she fought the fight using the microphone. She fought her fight using the stage.
Yeah.
That was very empowering. I can tell you, as a young girl watching her in Uganda, you know, I was in awe of her. So when I was approached by AWA, the organization here, to be a part of their PR team together with Miss Goto Girl Tatiana King,
yes.
I took on the
Shout
opportunity.
Out to my girl, Tatiana.
Yes. I took on the opportunity because I couldn't believe that this is a woman I used to watch back in the day, and then now I get to be a part of the team celebrating her.
Yeah.
So I tell people we're going to be showing a documentary, Mama. You need to come and find out who this woman was.
Yes, I'll make sure you show up because I'm honestly excited for that, especially knowing that. It's all about women too.
Yes.
We need to empower one another. You
Absolutely.
Know what I mean?
Definitely,
they support. We need that.
And on top of that, we're also going to be having the granddaughter, Zenzile.
Zenzile
Makeba.
Yes.
She sang with her on stage most of the times when you see her. You actually see her in the videos, in the documentary. So it's nice to... You know, she might be gone, but the granddaughter is here. And how many times do you celebrate an icon with a family member?
Not a lot. That's amazing.
So she'll be joining us, and she will also be performing on stage, and it's gonna be.
She's
great.
Also a singer, right?
Oh yes, of course.
Okay.
Of course she is.
Yeah.
It's in the family.
Runs in the family. Yeah.
Yes.
I was just about to say that's cool.
Yeah.
So what's your part?
My part, well, two parts.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm curating all the food. I'm bringing all the food. My company, Taste Lake, shout out to Taste Lake. So we invest in emerging markets. In Toronto, we invest in food, mm-hmm. chefs in particular. So we are bringing food from 5 different African countries. So there's oxtail, there's jerk chicken. These are all inspired cuisine from Africa through the Caribbean. So we are following the journey.
Right.
I'm working with a chef. Her name is Hedgewich. She's been part of the festival for about 2 years.
Yes, about two years.
Now. So she's going to be my main chef, but I'm also bringing other chefs as well.
Mm-hmm.
So that we want to have an incredible experience. So we're doing something called a passport, where you can get a booklet. It shows you what kind of food will be at the event, and you can go around, taste them, and get a stamp. So it's going to be all good.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my part, and I'm going
to
be
cool.
there looking to find, you know, chefs to invest in and, you know, grow their businesses. So, yeah.
That's so we're encouraging some female chefs out there.
Come out.
Definitely
Girl,
come out.
I'm a chef.
What? What?
Yes,
what? Well, let's talk. Let's
cook?
Talk after. Let's. Of course you can cook.
Me.
Do you want to run a business though? As a,
of course. All right.
So you have the
guy. So we can have a Tanzanian, you know, cruising and stuff.
Definitely.
Right?
Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
Hey.
That's a great idea.
Let's do it.
Let's
Who's
talk
down?
After.
And of course, with AWA, we're talking about women issues. We're talking when we talk about empowerment. This is something you have to face them. You have to face the issues before you know how to empower them. So. And that is what AWA is about.
Definitely,
for me
yeah.
to be able to see that these are African artists coming together,
yeah.
you know, to celebrate one another. That is a big deal. I don't
of
know.
Course.
It is a big deal because...
And they're all from different countries too,
yes.
right? So
yes.
coming to Canada all together, like...
Yes.
That's really big.
We have the likes of Faith Amar. We've got Queen Lamoy. she's going to be doing what is it? She's a poet.
Spoken word.
Mm-hmm. We've got, of course, Zenzile. We've got Arsène Duvet.
From Italy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Formerly Togolese.
Yeah.
Well, not formerly, but.
Italy, yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And also, well,
so exciting. Meseko. Yeah.
Yes, we have Meseko. Brilliant.
Yeah. He's Nigerian.
Humble. Very brilliant. Yeah. Very brilliant. So it's like a festival of everybody. Come and learn. Come and enjoy. Come and explore. Mm-hmm. I can't wait to taste all the food.
Honestly,
I'm like, looking forward to that. And also some of the vendors. So there's some art and craft being sold as well, and actually if you buy 3 and above tickets you get yourself a gift, some beautiful African artifacts, so you better
who doesn't want that, you know, beautiful
earrings, sandals, bracelets, it's good. I've seen them.
To learn a lot about different cultures and all that, which is That's cool. I like that.
It will be taking place at 720 Bathurst. That is the Center for Social Innovation. And look us out.
And this is what, May 11th?
May 11th.
That's
Saturday.
Mother's Day, right?
It starts at 2 p.m.
Yes. From 2 p.m. till 10 p.m.
Okay.
And this, again, it's going to be a party. But this is a party with a purpose. Because
so
we're
is
here
there any
celebrate.
After party party? I want to hear some African music.
There will be. Maybe we'll do some Afro beats after.
Yes. Oh my God, I'm so down.
It's going to be a DJ there. Well, the thing is about mixing the old and the new.
Yes.
It's like telling the entire African story through food, through
art, music, entertainment.
And I think that's how you can actually express a culture.
Absolutely.
And a people group. And we are elevating that profile a little bit. And, you know, and a legend like Maria Makaba, right? She's incredible, and being able to celebrate her life and bringing the entire Toronto to it. Whether you are African or not, you are invited to come and just celebrate and taste and listen and experience the entire, you know, continent right here in Toronto.
And also before the 11th, actually, we'll be having workshops. One is going to be, it's called 100 Voices Toronto, which is going to be facilitated by Arsène Duvet, the Togolese Italian artist. And he's merging what we call, he calls it polyphonic music. So you get parts of the African music. For those who don't know musically, the African scale is called a pentatonic scale. I'm taking you now. I'm taking you to class.
Was this high school?
It is called a pentatonic scale, which means you're not going to hear the regular do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. You'll only hear do, re, mi, sol, la.
Okay. That's
so he, yes, and he gets to merge these beautiful African African music pieces with modern day instruments, you know. And then it's going to be happening at 38 Regent Park. That is at the Regent Park Community Center. And it will be happening on the 10th, which is the Friday, from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m.
Yes.
So you cannot say you don't know.
Yes. Know what I mean?
And of course, you can register at www.africanwomenacting.org. Register for these workshops, and we shall also be having another workshop on the in May the 11th from 9 in the morning till about 5, and then the it's intertwined within the festival.
The big show,
absolutely.
Yeah.
So, yes, you gotta come and check us out. We're here to learn, explore, and have a good time.
And obviously empower one another. Like as a woman, you know, we have to support each other. I really like that. You know what I'm saying? Is there gonna be this? Like, are you guys gonna continuously doing this? Or you
Yeah, definitely. We're planning to do it every year now.
Yeah.
That's the goal.
Let's try to make it consistent. Yeah. You know, it's
exactly.
Yeah.
And I also want to encourage. You know, we might say it's African, but you know, it's for everybody.
Yeah.
And we're in, I call Toronto the global city center of the world.
100%.
Because you find every single person in Toronto.
Yeah.
So do not, don't say I don't want to come because it's not my thing. Come and find out if it's your thing or not.
Yeah,
and
you will not know until you're there.
You didn't know that he's a, she invests in food and you're a chef.
You know what I mean? There you go.
And I mean, always for every woman. Like we said, African women acting, but it's for every woman.
And the acting, I don't want people to mistake that for just acting as actors on stage and films. That acting means doing something about something, doing something about finding a solution to an issue.
To issues,
that is what the acting actually stands for in our. And there's so much. We are talking about domestic violence. We are talking about, let's even start with low self-esteem. Because in the entertainment industry, I know that usually men will have a better chance at getting the opportunity than women.
That's
and
true.
That is legit. As a performer,
we've
seen so many festivals, but we have not seen a woman being brought in Canada. You know, maybe the last
like
time.
Like the main.
Yes, as a main act.
Yeah.
So for me, something like that, we're here to empower. We're here to instill confidence in women. We're here to say, men, I'm sorry, but yeah, you do better with that. Well, you do better with that.
That's why we're part of it, right?
Yeah. Don't apologize. I mean, men love women, right? Don't we?
Yeah, we do.
We absolutely love. We do love them.
You better, because we do better together. Technically,
yeah,
we need each other to make it work.
I guess God brought us together
for a reason. Yeah. I wonder why.
Had a little break, you know. I need some water. these guys are making me nervous.
Well, you know what?
Especially this handsome one over here.
You know, so it's a little high. I'm making you just a little thirsty. That's a
right.
It's a glass of water.
So, talking about this event, what do you guys want the attendees to like expect from it? Like,
so at the event, we're gonna be screening a documentary about Mira Makeba.
Yeah.
It's gonna be from 3 p.m. So 3 p.m. Make sure you come before 3 p.m. because we have to enjoy the food.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Have to enjoy the drinks. We have good food.
And there's no feastings of African time.
Exactly. No African time here. You have to be on time.
So annoying.
Be there before 3 p.m.
Yes. 2 p.m. to be exact.
Exactly.
2 p.m. So
you don't want to miss out.
Yeah, the event starts at 2 p.m. actually.
Yes.
Right? So be there at 2 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Enjoy everything that we have for you. Yeah. The vendors. We have a lot of vendors coming. And then the movie, the screening will start at 3 p.m.
Mm.
And then after that, we have the show.
Yes, it's right. Jam-packed. So it's exactly. Like bada-bim, bada-boom. So
are they going to do the African drums and stuff like
you
that?
You have to wait and see.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
So
they have some surprises.
I love it. Mm-hmm.
And, of course, we want to say a special thank you to all our sponsors. First of all, our venue, that is the Center for Social Innovation, the CSI. We thank you so much. The City of Toronto as well. Ontario Council, thank you so much. And, of course, Tesla. There you go. For the PR and media, Miss Go-To Girl, thank you so much.
Yes, so
to the founders, the organization itself, putting it together, Sonia, thank you so much.
You,
together
Sonia.
With your team, yes. Thank you so much. And of course, thank you for having us.
Mm-hmm. Of course,
yes.
I got you. So one last thing.
I was going to say, the event itself, people want to know, is it free or not? Mm-hmm. So it is. The price is reduced. It's only $20.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, it's a huge event. And I think the value is about $100. Mm-hmm. So $20 in. Door.
It's $30 early bird tickets.
Yes.
Right? And
yes.
Then regular price is $30.
Yes.
Right?
So at the door, $30. If you pay online, it's $20.
Yes.
So register online at AfricanWomenActing.org.
Yeah.
And it's $20.
Or Eventbrite.
For the food portion as well, we are curating the entire food. So what you do is you buy a passport. You can use debit, credit, any type of medium, or even you can do PayPal if you want to do it. So you get your passport and you can go around and taste all the food as well.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want more, you can buy a ticket and you can get more. There are drinks as well. I think it's cash bar for the drinks.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And you can also, so bring lots of cash. But if you don't have cash, we'll have the square machines.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be.
Are you guys going to have ATM machine as well just in case?
Close by, it's right next to the subway station, and it's a CIBC.
Yeah.
So cash is
better.
Yeah, cash is better.
And of course, we forgot to thank the Miriam Makeba Foundation.
Yeah.
We thank you so much for this opportunity to be able to partner with our, to be able to give us the rights to show Mama Africa, because it's a big deal. Like, this is a big deal.
Especially having her granddaughter. Like,
I am telling you. So
this is like Michael Jackson we're talking about. A woman version. Like, this is amazing.
Yes, and we get to actually celebrate South Africa. So for me, I'm into D because I want to show, I like to show off people. I like to showcase and I say, guess what? Nabil is pretty good at this. Roger's pretty good at this. So
yeah.
To show, we are celebrating a woman who made a difference in not just her life, but in the life of very many people. What a great purpose that is.
And I love she had a quote saying, age is wisdom if one has lived properly. What do you think what that means?
Wow, age is wisdom. Age is wisdom if you live it properly. That's a good challenge. I mean, that alone, that statement alone instigates a conversation. Do you have time?
Oh, yeah, we got time, girl. Can you explain?
Well, age is wisdom. They always say that the older you get, the wiser. Being old doesn't necessarily mean that we look at it from the mortal section of it or the perspective where we are like, oh, my God, I'm old. But what have you done with that age? What have you done with it?
Yes.
But if you live it properly, if you look after yourself, if you live a life of purpose.
Yes. Okay.
And that goes for everybody. And it's a challenge to all of us.
Yeah.
If you live your life for a purpose, then you definitely
lived
are living it right. That's what it is, technically.
Oh, thank
like
you, guys.
I'm
so excited. Yes. Yeah, I'll get you tickets because myself, I'm going to be there. So I don't know about you, but trust me.
All right.
You know?
Thank you.
Well, thank you.
There's going to be some rappers there too, I have to say.
Which one?
There's going to be one rapper. He's from the Congo and he makes incredible music.
Sick.
And he's going to be there. Surprise. But come, there's going to be spoken word.
Oh my God.
Spoken word.
Surprise.
And so, no.
Drumming, dance.
Yeah, it's going to be, it's actually really jam packed with really good music. You know, you're going to get some of the old, some of the new.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it's going to be fun. We can
share. I need to find like an African dress for this one.
Yeah, you said African man for this one?
No,
dress. No, for dress.
Oh my God, this guy.
Wow. I'm like, an African dress. All right,
yeah. African men, I'm going to be there, right? It's not only
it's
a woman
event.
It's going to
be a bunch of good African men there.
Yes.
Yeah, and don't forget to follow us.
So thank you so much, first of all, for having us in
well,
your beautiful studio.
Well, thank you
studio.
For being here.
Yes.
Yeah, we definitely had to get you guys here so we can talk more about this hour because obviously we're interested and we want to know more about it.
Mm.
And for Miriam Makeba.
Yes.
So it's amazing to have you guys. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're
thank
welcome.
You so much for having us.
And I can't wait to see you.
Yes. Yes, I can't wait to see everyone. So
yeah,
please come on out.
Make sure
come
you're there.
Out. Yes.
Get your ticket if you haven't.
Yes.
It's gonna be amazing.
You're
and you don't have to be African to be there.
Mm-mm.
You can be Chinese, my girl, just show up. Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.